here's a double team, and right there's an excellent example of the quickness. I mean, they are trapping in that corner when the ball goes to baseline. I don't think we've seen anybody yet this year that was able to get that ball trapped in the corner.
Yeah, I agree. And as Murphy gets it out of there, Schaefer for Culver pushes Malco out of bounds, so she picks up her team's first here in the first quarter. Malco around the defense to X at the elbow, extended left. Down to Malco, top of the key. Malco gets Schaefer behind her back dribble. Out to X. Makes a three. Now drives inside the arc. Floating jumper on the baseline is no good. Zainer on the board. Gives it to Llewellyn.
Collins taking all four shots for the Rochester. Missed them all.
Schaefer down low to Hardy. Hardy against Pollock. Backs away in. Payne kicks it out to Llewellyn. Now goes in the backcourt. It'll be an over-the-back call. And Rochester will get it back after off the turnover.
If she can get on track like she did Saturday night, that'll start to open up that 2-3 defense a little bit.
Oh, that was a great piece of work there by B. Pollock, bodying up Hardy, but yet not picking up a foul.
Right, yeah, you're right.
X in the paint, loses the handle, ball loose. B gets it out to Murphy, three on the way to cut the lead in half, no good. Stasiak to put back is no good. And Zainer, another board. Gives it to Llewellyn. Culver runs up by six, 5.5 to play in the first quarter. Well, on the baseline to Schaefer, makes right, goes left, throws up a jumper over Murphy, no foul, a lot of contact, misses the shot. Stasiak with the rebound, gets to Malco.
Schaefer's going to create problems for Rochester, 5'10 in the guard position.
Murphy throws up a shot, no good. B's putback is going, and Rochester's on the board. Well, we talked in the pregame how Culver likes to bang, and they're doing that here early on.
Yeah, they are.
5 minutes of play, first quarter. Culver up 6-2.
And the 10 girls on the floor right now might be the only 10 you see all night.
You're right.
Somebody gets in real bad foul trouble.
Schaefer's spot up three is short. Malco with the board, she runs. Becky runs to her left down the right side of the floor. Becky gets Schaefer, kicks it out to X, makes it three, now gives to Murphy, top of the key. Murphy, bounce pass her. Malco right side, dribbles to the baseline, throws up a shot. She's going to be fouled on the shot, and that's going to be whistled against Hardy. And that's going to send Becky Malco for Rochester to the line to shoot two.
You hate to see Lexi start passing up wide open three-pointers.
Yeah, I agree.
She needs to dial in her shot.
And maybe that's what Coach Duziak here will talk to her about. Out with the line. First one for the sophomore. No good. She'll have one more. In the game for the first time for the Lady Cav. We're going to have to get that number for you with that name.
31.
Yep. Oh, here it is. Montgomery. Alana Montgomery, 5'6 junior, just appeared on my paper out of thin air. Malco hits one of two, cuts the lead in half and 6-3. Culver the lead in the basketball, 4:40 to play in the first quarter. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. Through the center circle comes Llewellyn. High on the left side to Montgomery, in the corner to Schaefer, back to Montgomery, high on the left side, middle of the floor, through Llewellyn, hands in the center circle, now works, drives it right. Baseline to Schaefer, gives to Zainer, the elbow extended, sets back behind the arc, cross court pass to Montgomery, to Zainer, back to Llewellyn, the volleyball line, and Culver will reset up by three. Montgomery, a couple of dribbles, picks up a dribble against Rochester's 1-3-1 zone, maybe a 2-3 zone now. And lob pass goes to Schaefer in the baseline. Schaefer penetrates, throws up a shot, short, rebound to Murph. Rochester runs to our left, down by three. Murphy, left wing, dribbles in on the paint, blocked by Zainer, picked up by Zainer on the rebound. Donna Zainer dribbles out of trouble, now gives to Llewellyn, and she runs to our right. 6:40 to play in the first quarter. Culver up 6-3. Schaefer baseline to Zainer. Zainer against Pollock, throws it out to Llewellyn. She passes up in three, dribbles top of the key to Montgomery, left side to Schaefer. Lob pass to the lane to Hardy. Kicks it out to Llewellyn. Nice shot by Rochester, cutting off that three shot by Llewellyn. Schaefer down low to Zainer. Zainer's shot over the defense is good.
Charlie Murphy doing all she can without picking up the foul. And
Murph gives up about 3 or 4 inches.
Six.
Yeah. 8-3, Culver. Malco loses the handle, but he's there to pick it up. Down to X in the paint. Feeds down low to Stasiak. Her jumper inside the window is good. And his lead is cut to three. It's 8-5. 3 minutes of play in the first quarter. Llewellyn now walks it up. As Hurlmeyer shouts instructions to Montgomery, she comes up the sideline. Schaefer, 1-3-1 zone by the Lady Zebras. Gives to Montgomery right wing. She picks a dribble elbow to Hardy. Right baseline to Schaefer. Schaefer penetrates. He's down a little hardy. First shot is good. A foul. Nice ball movement there by Kayla Schaefer to find a wide open Hardy. And Hardy hits the bucket, and she'll have one free throw for the Lady Cavs.
Stasiak will pick up her first. I mean, you're looking at Schaefer 5'10", Hardy at 5'11", Zahner at 5'10", makes it awful tough.
Shot by Hardy goes. And Culver back up by 6, which is the biggest lead of the game for the Lady Cavs. 11-5 with 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Becky Falco works hard right side. Down to Murph behind the wings. Behind the arc right side, I should say. Murph pull-up jumper from 12 feet is short. And the rebound to X. Holland behind the arc. Out drives left side. Down low to Stasiak. Loses the handle to paint. Gives to B. Kicks it outside to Murph. 3 on the way, right wing. Good!
Good 3-pointer by Carly Murphy. Lady Zebras could use a few more of those.
Yeah. Culver back up by 3 after a big 3-point bomb by Carly Murphy. 2 minutes to play in the first quarter, 11-8. Culver. Montgomery backs it out. Now gives him the right wing to Zahner. Gives him the corner to Schaefer. Schaefer, nobody in her face. Set up 3. No good. And the rebound to Murphy. That's almost like a set shot. The last 3 threes for Schaefer.
Right.
Falco, out to Murph, hesitates, now penetrates, goes left, shoots, nope, and the ball is batted out of bounds by Hardy. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. And Marissa Howard back into the game for Culver, and Kayla Schaefer will sit down. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. A minute 40 to play, first quarter, Rochester down 11-8. Falco drives right, shot over Hardy, high off the glass, no good. Zahner, another board. That's got to be at least 5 for Donna Zahner in this quarter. 90 seconds to play, first quarter. Culver up by 3, 11-8. Angela Llewellyn, high on left side to Howard. Couple of dribbles back to Llewellyn, who swings right side to Montgomery. Montgomery looking for Howard on the right block. Has her ball tipped away and stolen by Murphy. Murphy, middle of the floor, at the free throw line. Stop, jump pass to Malco. Her shot blocked from behind. Zahner picks it up, trying to save her from out of bounds. It's going to be a loose ball on the floor, going to be tied up. And it will stay with Rochester. Donna Zahner is all over the play.
Yes.
Good heavens. A minute 5 to play first quarter. Rochester ball baseline left. Stasiak gets the ball inbounds, and we're going to have one official calls a foul, the other calls a tie up. It's going to be a foul on Montgomery, and it'll be back out of bounds to Rochester.
Montgomery's first, team third.
63 seconds to play first quarter. Culver by 3. Holland looks to get it in, does so to Stasiak. Keen, a couple of dribbles, top of the key to Murph, back in the corner to Axel, fire a 3 for the tie. In and out, no good. The rebound put back by Stasiak, no good, partially blocked by Zahner, and Donna picks up the rebound. 11-8, Culver. 45 seconds of play in the first quarter. The Lady Cavs with the basketball going to our right. Howard, one bounce. Gives to Montgomery, who one bounce against the double team. Out to Howard, now quickly left side to Llewellyn. Elbow, back to back out to the volleyball line and resets for Culver. He gives to Howard, now to Montgomery with 30 seconds. Bounce pass back to Howard to the timeline. Cross court to Llewellyn with 28. Down to Zahner, who stands behind the arc left side. She drives the baseline, runs over Stasiak. We're going to have a charge on Donna Zahner.
And Stasiak hurt, rolled up on that ankle that she hurt a few weeks ago.
Team still down. Still down, face down on the floor, still trying to get up. She gets up, favoring that left leg. She's trying to make it. I'm not sure. She's barely putting any weight on it. Coach Stasiak just stands on the sideline looking. Still looking, trying to walk it off, and she's going to do it. Man, she is a trooper. Tough. 23.3 to play in the first quarter. Rochester looking for the final shot of the quarter. Down by 3. Holland with 14 holds against the zone. With 12, holds with 10. One dribble, gives to Malco, high on the right side with 8. Couple of dribbles in the volleyball line with 6. She drives, pulls it back out to Murph with 3. Murphy inside the lane. Her throws up a shot, a lot of contact, no foul. But so good, Zahner on the board. After 1, Culver leads 11-8. You're listening to high school basketball, 92.1 WROI.
You make a sound investment when you choose a New Holland T9 Series 4-wheel drive tractor from New Holland Rochester. You get big engine and hydraulic power and up to 10% cost savings thanks to cutting-edge Echo Blue SCR engine technology. It saves you money on fuel, and ground speed management adjusts both engine and transmission speeds for better field performance and economy. Stop by New Holland Rochester and see what New Holland T9 T9 Series four-wheel drive tractors can do for your operation. New Holland, Rochester, Highway 25 South.
And we're all about pets.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all about pets.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Welcome back to Culver Community High School. We're going to the second quarter right now. The Lady Cavs leading the Rochester Lady Zebras 11-8. And the game has been back and forth. The biggest lead of the quarter has been 6 with the Lady Cavs. Rochester trying to fight back. Alexa Garrison, the new freshman for Rochester in the game, is Dean Stasiak having that left ankle taped.
I'll tell you what, the size and the speed of these Lady Cavaliers really giving Rochester fits.
Here comes a little half-court trap by the Rochester Lady Zebras. Montgomery looks to pass over, and she gets away with the travel. No, we're going to have a timeout by the Lady Cavs.
Well, just as they threw it away.
Yeah, Rochester, they threw it away. Culver will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now the basketball, swimming, and wrestling are back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
WROI. Back at Culver, after the Lady Cavalier timeout, we'll have the basketball right in front of the Rochester bench. 11-8, Lady Cavs, 7:46 to play in the second quarter. Llewellyn gets the inbound pass from Montgomery. Looks to the baseline to Schaefer. Behind the arc, lobs down low to Hardy. Hardy over, Spekchalko, good. Serious matchup when the bigs are down low, and yeah. Becky Malcolm
five,
is trying to stop the shot.
5-5 trying to block 5-11.
Yeah. Good work usually.
No.
13-8, Culver. Holland high on the right side. Now Malcolm near the center circle on the left side. Malcolm in the paint. Wrap around pass down to Gear. Her shot blocked, picked up by Hardy. A lot of contact, no foul. Hardy now gives to Llewellyn. Dean Stasiak has her left ankle wrapped. She's putting on her shoe, and imagine she'll be going back to the scorer's bench here shortly. A minute gone to the second quarter. Rochester down 13-8. Hardy again to the paint. She's going to be fouled before the shot, I would believe. It will be out of bounds. Who will that be whistled on, Malco or Pollard?
I'm guessing Malco, but we'll see.
Yeah.
Becky Malco trying to come in and step in between that into the passing lane between the passer and the ball. Was a little late getting there.
Howard back into the game for Culver. I'm sorry, yeah, Howard back in and Montgomery to sit.
Of course, if she was standing behind Harding, you'd never even see her there. So
Keaton Stasiak will come back in and Garrison will sit down. 6:58 to play in the first half, 13-8 Culver. Rochester has never led. Howard gets it in to Llewellyn over the defense of Stasiak. Llewellyn drives to the left wing, now drives to right in the paint, and she's going to be fouled in the paint. Holy cow.
Lady Zebras might find themselves in foul trouble here before too long as Malco picks up her second.
Out of bounds is Howard, baseline left. Coach Stasiak looks up and down his bench. That didn't take long. Down to Llewellyn in the right corner.
Of course, you got Schaefer and Hardy both, or Zahner and Hardy both working that paint real hard.
Yeah.
They're really bumping to try and make a spot for themselves.
Schaefer picks her way through the double team and loses the handle to Murphy. Turnover, Culver, Rochester with it. Murphy brings it up. Down by five. Murphy high on the right wing is the 2-3 zone of the Lady Cavs. Murphy down low to Stasiak. She is fouled on the shot by Hardy, and that's going to be Hardy's second. That's going to send Keaton to the line to shoot two. So Keaton Stasiak, one of the three sophomores for the Lady Zebras, at the line to shoot two. We're going to cut this lead of the Cavaliers to two, three, that is. Keaton ready, pushes the first one, lets her fly, it is good. as it hangs on the rim briefly and falls through. Harrison back into the game, and Becky Malko with two personals will sit. 6:26 to play in the second quarter. Rochester has one more free throw. Keaton Stasiak eyes the second one, lets her fly, and it's good again. 13-10 Culver, and the Lady Cavs with the basketball. 1-2-2 zone this time for the Lady Zebras. Garrison at the top of that zone. Duell looks at the three, passes it up. Good defense by X. Top to Howard. One bounce to Schaefer on the left side. Schaefer one bounce to the center circle by Howard. Now right side of Llewellyn, who stands 15 feet away from the three-point line with 6 minutes playing the first half. Lob in the corner to Schaefer. Schaefer looking for Howard. She loses the basketball to Holland. Rochester runs to our left after the turnover. Holland works to the right wing. Hesitates, pulls it back outside. Still dribbling, looking for B down low. Cross court to Stasiak. Deep in the lane, out to Murphy. Murphy at the free throw line. Now she backs it out behind the arc. Gives cross court to X. X, three on the way, right wing. Good! And we're tied at 13.
Coach Stasiak was hollering to get that ball reversed and reverse it in a hurry. He was looking for that outside open shot.
5.5 to play first half. We're tied at 13 here at Culver Community High School. Hardy in the lane, jumper over. Murphy is good.
That's going to be hard to find an answer for.
Yeah. Nice job by Hardy using the backboard. You don't see that very often in the middle of the lane.
Yeah, shooting over the front of the rim off the backboard.
What it there for. Murphy, a quick three. Nope. And the rebound to Hardy. Nice. Good idea.
Good shot. She was wide open. They didn't respect her ability to shoot from out there. She almost made it.
5 minutes to play. First half, Culver by two. Schaefer drives left against Stasiak. Throws up a shot on the baseline. No good. Rebound is saved from going out of bounds by Hardy. But as she does so, throws it around across court out of bounds. And it'll go back to Rochester down by two. 4:52 to play, first half. Culver up 15-13, and Rochester with the basketball going to our left. 2-3 zone by the Lady Cavs. Murphy backs it out to the center circle, resets for Rochester. Now high on the right side to Holland, back to Murphy. Murphy inside the arc, cut off by the triple team. 15 feet away from the basket, gives to Stasiak. Stasiak back to Murph. Murphy on the left wing, dribbles down to the top of the key, swings right side to Holland, now battles left side to Murphy. Murphy passed over Schaefer, yeah. Schaefer tips it out of bounds.
She cannot do that. I was just going to say, with Schaefer, 5'10", playing the top point on that defense, if she's got speed and the length to take away a lot of passing lanes. You've got to make that extra dribble to the top of the key
right
before you can pass to the other side of the floor.
15-13 Culver. Murphy penetrates a 2-3 zone. Out to X for the lead. Nope, too hard. And the weak side rebound. It goes out of bounds. X try, or make that Harrison tried to save him from going out of bounds, but could not. It'll go back to the Cavaliers. Again, the JV team tonight won 20-14. To Ray Carpenter at 10 for the Lady Zebras in that big win. Hardy at the free throw line. Kicks it out. To Llewellyn, top of the key, now left side to Schaefer. Schaefer holds on the left wing. Rochester in a 1-3-1 zone still. We've seen that a lot this year. We have not seen a lot of man, but we have seen it.
Yeah. As I say, Murphy can't get too can't concentrate too much on Zahner because it leaves Hardy when she comes off the free throw lane wide open on the opposite block.
Rochester foul on Alexa Garrison. With 3:36 to play in the first half, Rochester trails the Lady Cavs 15-13. Rochester has not led in this game. They have been tied once, and that come moments ago at 13. Well, jump pass down low to Zahner. Zahner throws up a shot. It's good. She out-muscled B. Pollock down low and picked up her sixth point of the game.
Eighth.
Her eighth point of the game, as Boyd said, and pushes this lead to four. Murphy on the wing behind the arc.
She needs to shoot that.
Next against Schaefer. Around the defense from Murphy left wing. Around the defense. Baseline jumper from 10 feet. No good. Ball tipped around. And Schaefer picks it up. Schaefer on the breakaway. Right-handed layup is good.
I think Charlie Murphy needs to recognize that at 5'10", Schaefer guarding her at 5'10", that she needs to back up a little bit when she shoots that ball.
Murph, lob pass inside. Tipped out of bounds by Hart. Hardy. It'll stay with Rochester. Baseline right with 2:42 to play in the first half. Lady Cavs now back up by six. And back into the game because of Montgomery. And Hardy sits down.
And we talked about Carly Murphy only being able to drive into the defense and get that shot up and call and draw the contact. But when you got 5'10 guarding you, you're not going to get that same kind of guard, you know, contact. You're going to get the block. The call block.
Yeah. So Pollock gets the inbound pass and misses the shot. And Zahner, another board. 2:20 to play in the first half. Ball from 19-13, baseline to Zahner. Zahner holds the ball above her head. Left wing to Montgomery, now to Llewellyn. Llewellyn backs it to the timeline and resets. Schaefer now left elbow. Schaefer, 15-foot jumpers in and out, no good. And the rebound to Holland. X runs to our left. Rochester down by six. Holland left wing, hesitates, now in the lane. Goes to the shot, he's going to be fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
A foul's coming against Llewellyn, her first, team six.
2 minutes to play, first half. Rochester down by six. And Alexa Holland at the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras. First one on the way is no good off the back of the rim. She'll have one more.
It's the first shot I think she's taken tonight with paper in her face.
Second one by X. Good this time.
It's going to be hard for her to find a shot when she's being guarded by Shea Wright.
Under 2 to play, first half. Culver by 5. A little half-court trap coming by the Lady Zebras. There it is. The pass is out of it, and now Culver will take a 30-second timeout. High school girls basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra basketball, WROI.
1:52 to play in the second quarter. The Lady Cavaliers lead the Rochester Zebras right now in 19-14. And after Culver's timeout, which they've had to burn two now, when Rochester throws that half-court trap at them, has the basketball. And they're going to throw it at him again. Llewellyn across the timeline to Zahner. Here comes the run and jump. Defense. Over the hot top of the defense to Montgomery. Now back to Llewellyn. Over the top to Zahner. Zahner drives right. Drives it to the block. Throws him a shot. No good. Ball being tipped around. Montgomery comes out of there with it. She's fouled the shot by Stasiak. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Stasiak will pick up her second. So now Stasiak and Malco both with two.
Becky's been on the bench for a while. And Alana Montgomery, the 5'6 junior, will go to the line for Culver, looking for two freebies here. With a minute 35 to play in the first half, first on the way for the junior's good. Malcolm will come back into the game. And Garrison will sit. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman, Culver Community High School. And a game we figure to be tight from start to finish, and it has been this half.
A little bit of a gamble here by Coach Stasiak with both Malco and Stasiak in the ballgame with two fouls.
Montgomery misses the second one. Lead still at six for Culver, 20-14. Malco to X. Back to Malco, throws it out of bounds. Malco wasn't expecting it. So I don't think that was a play that was drawn up by Coach Stasiak and chucked it out of bounds. So Culver will get it back with a minute 20 to play in the first half, up by six, which is the biggest lead of the game for the Lady Cavs. Zahner looks for Schaefer at the free throw line, has her now at the elbow. Schaefer now dribbles outside the three-point line. Now to Zahner, quickly to Llewellyn, who swings to Montgomery high on the left side. 1-3-1 zone by Rochester to Howard, to Montgomery, back to Llewellyn. A couple of dribbles to our right. Looks back at her coach, Perlmeyer. Sets the Lady Cavs, under a minute to play in the first half, up by six. Culver the basketball on the lead with her foot on the line. Schaefer the long jumper, no good. Llewellyn, the putback is good. Llewellyn had a wide open shot at the basket because Rochester and Culver both fell down and created a huge window.
Yeah.
8-point lead now for Culver with 30 seconds. Three for X, short. Out to the rebound, gives to Murphy at 25. She backs it out. Now drives it right. Gives to Holland. X down to Malco, top of the key with 20. Murphy for three, left side, way too long. And Schaefer the rebound with 15. Over the top of the defense to Llewellyn with 12. Crosses the timeline with 11. Back to Schaefer with 9. Culver by 8 with 7. Schaefer has her pocket pick. X picks it up. We're going to have a foul on Kaylee Schaefer. And that's going to send Rochester to the line for one of the bonus with 5.3 to play in the first half.
Schaefer will pick up her second.
And quickly, Earlmile will go to the bench. And ringing us up.
Good defensive effort by Alexa Holland. She was able to get her hand on that ball just as Schaefer tried to make a move and tapped it behind her and then grabbed a hold of it. Schaefer tried to come up over the top of her, got higher up, and it got called for the foul.
Next at the first quarter, she'll have one more. Looking to cut this lead back to 6 with 5.3 to play in the first half. Over up 22-15. Holland ready. Fires the second one. Good again. 22-16. Full court press by Rochester. Llewellyn over the top to Montgomery with 3. Montgomery. Left side. The jumper at the buzzer is no good. At halftime, Culver lead 22-16. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
...1702 Main Street in Rochester, or at MikeAnderson.com. Remember, we've got credit. Come and get it at Mike Anderson Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram. To qualified buyers with approved credit.
WROI.
Going to the third quarter here at Culver Community High School. The Lady Cavaliers lead 22-16. Rochester Brad will start with the basketball foul.
Hardy and Schaefer for the Cavaliers with 2 apiece, and Malco and Stasiak with 2 apiece for the Lady Beavers.
Here comes a run and jump defense by the Lady Cavs. Malco dribbles away from it, gives to Stasiak in the baseline, drives around Hardy, down low to Murphy. Murphy, leaner, blocked, picked up by Llewellyn. Blocked behind by Hardy, blocked in front by Zahner. Down low to Zahner. Zahner in the paint, she walked before the shot. Oh, we're going to have a foul before the shot.
Ooh.
So before the shot, Donna Zahner was hit the side of the head. It'll be out of bounds to Culver baseline left.
So Holland will pick up her first, team first of the half.
She had a monster first half, did Donna Zahner.
Yeah, she did. She had 8 points, leads all scorers right now.
Schaefer for three, nope. And the rebound to Culver. Llewellyn has it out top of the key, and they reset as they look at the 1-3-1 zone. The side to Howard. One dribble behind the arc gives Schaefer the volume of light between the circles. Down to Llewellyn, who stands in the center circle, high on the right side to Schaefer. Schaefer down to Howard. Now left side to Llewellyn. Llewellyn, a couple of dribbles to the left. Now looks back door to Hardy and has it taken away by Pollock. Good job by Balco. Not letting Culver go back door.
Yeah, Hardy trying to sneak in for the back door. Malco saw him coming and stepped in the way, so Hardy couldn't get a hold of it.
We saw that exact same play here last Wednesday night that resulted in an alley-oop dunk.
I don't think we're going to see that tonight, but the boys team for Culver, they've got some athletes.
Texas shot too hard, and the rebound grabbed by Schaefer, and she'll run. Schaefer then has it knocked away from behind by Malco. It'll stay with Culver baseline left, 6:45 to play in the third, 22-16, the Lady Cavaliers. Howard looks to get it in. Baseline left. Does go to Llewellyn on the baseline. She'll fire a three. Nope. Rebound by Zahner. Boy, that's a heavy play.
She's got Murphy blocking her out. Malco coming in underneath trying to get the rebound, and she still came up with it.
Zahner fell to the floor, let the ball basically drop on the floor. She regained a dribble a couple times and was able to find somebody in white.
Yeah.
She on the baseline loses it to Holland. Holland out of Pollock. Who gives to Malco. Turnover, Culver. Rochester runs. Down by 6, nice behind the back dribble. He's down low to Pollock. He dribbles out of trouble. She's got to get rid of it. Now does to Holland before she travels. Baseball pass to Murphy. Just inside the arc. Jumper over Hardy is too long. And the ball to X. It gives to Murphy. Murphy, the leaner off the window, is good on it.
Good coming play by Holland.
Yeah.
Throwing out of bounds and find Murphy underneath.
Kept it alive. I don't think anybody would know that she had a 24-hour flu bug just last night. Against the half-court trap, Zahner, to Hardy, to Howard, to Hardy, at the elbow, jumper, good.
don't know why Hardy even hesitated in the first place. That was just almost looked automatic from that point.
Back to a six-point lead for the Lady Cavs. 5.5 to play in the third. 24-18. Rochester with the basketball going to our right. Malco in the corner to Murphy. Murphy, one dribble around the defense to Malco, quickly to X. Fakes three in the paint. And the ball is kicked away. The pass is kicked away by Schaefer, who will stay with Rochester right in front of the Rochester bench. I think Coach Stasiak saying, hey, shoot it.
Yeah.
Shoot from my
right.
Heart.
Like I said, Schaefer is just so long, and at 5'10", at the top of that key, just really makes it difficult to get that ball reversed around on the floor.
Over to what looks like a 2-3 zone, but it could be a 1-2-1 zone. Stasiak, couple of dribbles, high to the left by to Holland. Selection to Malco, to Murphy, runs the baseline, cut off by the double team, wrap around, pass to Stasiak, her jumper, good. Lead is cut to four. Cavaliers on top and with the basketball. Schaefer now runs the point for Lady Cavs. Gives to Llewellyn. Over the defense to Zahner. Zahner down low to Howard. Her pass Hardy out to Schaefer. Schaefer leaner over Malco's no good. And Stasiak comes out there with the basketball. Keaton. Wrap around pass to Murphy. And now she gives ahead to Malco. Rochester down by four and run. Malco out to Holland. X in the right corner. Top to Murphy. Murphy, the elbow. No look pass to Pollock. Wide open. Jumper is good. 24-22. Culver takes a 60-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
As long as the kids keep making the traveling team and the new restaurant across town doesn't deliver, you're going to be driving. So it's a smart choice to join new BP Driver Rewards. You receive an instant 10 cents per gallon reward just for signing up. With every second fill up of quality BP gasoline, you keep earning and saving 5 cents per gallon. Pick up a BP Driver Rewards brochure at your local BP to join now. Up to 20 gallons, terms and conditions apply. See bpdriverrewards.com for details.
A new dual car wash combining both soft cloth and high pressure technology for a really clean car is coming to the Good to Go Car Wash. Purchase your wash at either Good to Go locations and save up to 20 cents per gallon on your gas purchase. Give it a try beginning November 1st.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:21 to play in the third quarter. Rochester cut this lead. That was 1-8-2 at 24-22. The closest they've been has been with through the second at 13-13.
About 13-13. Yeah, you're right. Great job rebounding for the Lady Zebras. She's down there all by herself amongst the trees with Harding, Schaefer, Zahner. She still was able to pull that rebound down, get it back down the other floor. Murphy did a great job of finding Pollock on the opposite block for a wide open layup.
The key to the rebound, I believe, was she didn't grab it to stand there. She grabbed it and ran away from the height. And now we have a turnover. Stasiak has it. We'll go coast to coast. She's going to be fouled. The shot's looking to like to shoot two.
Again, Stasiak coming up with the steal and taking immediately, turning and taking it to the other end of the floor. And catching Marissa Howard in a blocking foul.
Tough as nails. Almost had to come out of the game earlier because of a left ankle injury. She got her wrapped up. And yeah, you can't even tell, especially when she runs, you can't tell. But she's a little jiffy on the left side. Free throw by Keane is no good. We're coming from the sophomore. 24-22 Culver, 4:09 to play in the third. Brad Thomas, I'm David Buffalo. Second for Keaton. Nice second one. Right-handed free throw is good. Nothing but net. And the lead is cut to one. 24-23. Here comes Roma half-court trap. Llewellyn brings it up the floor. To Howard, to Zahner. Have not yet crossed the timeline. Does so finally to Llewellyn. Llewellyn picks up a great dribble. She loses the handle. Ball loose to backcourt. Picked up by Culver. They come ahead down. X ties it up. Down that little Zahner. Zahner over Stasiak. Keaton's going to be fouled, or Culver found the push. And that's going to, yep, that's going to be out of bounds to Culver baseline left.
Stasiak is 5-5 trying to play defense against 5-10 Zahner underneath. And they called her on the push as the ball came into Zahner.
That's three fouls for Keaton Stasiak, the coach. Stasiak will probably go to the bench here shortly. Llewellyn gets the inbound pass all the way to 15-footer is no good. And now Stasiak has the rebound and run, and Llewellyn just picks up a foul on the reach in on the earth second.
Stasiak once again will go to the free throw. No, outbound, sorry.
24-23. Alexa Garrett will come back into the game, and Keaton will sit down with three personal fouls. That hurts. So Malco brings up the floor. She'll run the play for Rochester. No defense, no man-to-man defense right now from the Lady Cavs. And we have not seen a lot of that for either team. Murphy in the paint, leaner over Hardy, partially blocked. And Spanner comes up with the rebound. Man-to-man, I really think Murphy needs to pull it out beyond the arc and bring Hardy with it. I agree. If that's who Murphy's matched up with. Spanner gets the pass down low from Schaefer. She puts the prayer up and it goes. Donna Vader is going to be approaching 10 points.
He does have 10.
And she's approaching seriously a double-double there tonight if she's not already there.
That's got her 8 rebounds.
Malco in the paint. Taken away by Vader. She ties up. And the ball in the back. Yeah, on the turnover. 26-23. Llewellyn to Howard. Across the sideline to Schaefer. Schaefer splits the defense. Little good pass to Hardy. Layup is good.
Nobody that can get guarded against that as Schaefer just turns around and dribbles over and around everybody.
Rochester now down by 5. Leaner for Murphy is no good, and Hardy comes flying in from somewhere and grabbing the board.
You gotta think about what this team would be like with Tatum Schultz before right now.
You're right. Wow. 2:45 to play in the third. Culver by 5, and they just hold the basketball. Schaefer backs it out away from Garrison. Holland says, hey, both Alexis, get up on there and guard Schaefer. Poor freshman. It's tough, strong, regardless of your age, to get Schaefer right.
They find a Howard, 10-footer, good.
Just keeps the floor so well,
says Schaefer.
30-23, lead back to 7, 10-20 to play in the third quarter. Culver in the lead, not just the basketball. At the free throw line, backs out, resets, loses the handle, picks up her dribble, drives it left in the paint, and she's going to be pumped by Llewellyn, and it's going to be out of bounds for Rochester.
See Llewellyn third.
27 Culver, 208 to 20 to third. Rochester basketball team playing right. Heck will be the trigger person. Llewellyn looks deep it in. Over the defense to Murphy, right side, first drive, kicks it out to Spinoco.
Here we got a 7-point lead. Let's work the ball. Howard to Llewellyn. Llewellyn a couple of dribbles to the right. Down the center circle. Back left to Howard. Down the corner to Schaefer. Down low to Zahner. Zahner puts up a 5-footer. No good. And we're going to have the basketball go out of bounds. Last touch by Hardy. And as we go back to Rochester, down by 7 with a minute 39 to play in the third quarter.
Runs away from the defense. Down low to Zahner. Over her head and out of bounds. A minute 7 to play in the third. Culver still up by 7. Rochester basketball. Collins on the jog across the timeline with 60 seconds. Collins gets the well on the man-to-man defense. Collins right side.
Schaefer chases Murphy all over the floor.
Murphy has it now again. Schaefer inside the three-point line. Out of Malco, wraparound pass to Pollock. Speed jumper is good. Nice feed by Pollock. Makes up Malco. Good finish by Pollock. The lead is cut to 5. 37 seconds to play in the third. Llewellyn to Hardy on the left side with 30. Back to Llewellyn down right side to Hamilton with 29. Down low to Hardy. Back to the way in. Throws up a shot. It's good.
Hardy finding herself wide open. Down low in the paint.
located in your True Value Hardware store. 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one-coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects, plus expert local advice at Endurance True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Endurance True Value. Start right. Start here.
Local people making a big difference when it comes to insurance needs. Insurance does not have to be complicated. That's why Smith, Sawyer, and Smith Insurance are your local trusted choice agent. They have access to multiple insurance carriers that offer competitive pricing and individual coverage. Call 574-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Fourth quarter we go. It's been a back-and-forth game. Rochester's been as close as 13-13 and haven't been as close as one in this half. They've got it down to 24-23. But Rochester now down by four and 32-28. And Coach Stasiak's message between quarters, they're tired. Yes, let's keep running them. Let's keep running them. They're tired. Let's keep running them.
And rebound. Get yourself in position. There's a couple times where they let the ball hit the floor. He wants them to get there and get that ball.
32-28 Culver. Rochester basketball. Spun up shot in the lane. No good. Pollock putback is good. Rochester within two. 32-30. Culver with the lead of the basketball. Here comes the half-court trap. Almost over the back. Deep. Pollock steals the basketball. Gives to X. Rochester's opportunity here to tire to take the lead. On the right wing. Around the defense to Murphy. Down low to Pollock. It's tipped away and stolen by Schaefer. She missed the other first player. Stasiak wide open.
Yeah. Yep. That's hard to get that down there, but the tall tree.
Hard to get the wide open pass from Schaefer. She puts it in for an easy two.
Seen that happen more than once tonight. That's the first time Schaefer has seen it.
Yeah.
Where the opposite block is wide open for the Lady Cavs.
34-30. Culver the lead. Rochester the basketball. Malco handles the bad pass for Murphy. She picks up and drives it left in the lane. Floater off the window is too hard. And Stainer with another board. 34-30 Culver. Lady Cavs the basketball. Early in the fourth quarter. Just past the Hardy at the free throw line. Outside to Schaefer. Passes up the three. Gets to Howard out of the Llewellyn. Rochester 2-3 zone. Back door to wide open Schaefer. She loses it right in the hands of Stasiak. Stasiak now runs. Down by four. Keaton in the lane. Took up coast to coast. She's going to be called. Actually, she was going to be fouled by Llewellyn. And Stasiak will go to the line to shoot two. With 6:29 to play in the game.
Llewellyn will pick up her fourth.
Coming back into the game is Montgomery for Culver after the first free throw by Keaton Stasiak. Looking to cut this lead to two with two freebies.
Well, regardless of the outcome of the ball game, that's going to be a bright spot tonight for the Lady Beavers. So their free throw shooting has been the best they've had all season.
Keaton first was good. And Montgomery back into the game, and Llewellyn will sit out, and now Coach Stasiak will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Girl Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Come check out the amazing deals at the Winning Edge in Rochester. You'll find really huge savings this holiday season. They offer in-store specials, and they have the equipment, backpacks, and duffels for your favorite sport or gift-giving need. They carry major apparel brands, including Under Armour, Russell, Adidas, and so many more. So visit their webpage, thewinedge.com, or their Facebook page. Call 574-223-6090. Quality products, unique customizing options, and friendly service from the Winning Edge, Rao Place Drive in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
6:29 to play in the game. Rochester down 34-31. The Lady Cavaliers have led the entire basketball game. And King Stasiak after the Rochester timeout with one more freebie.
Yeah, play Zebra's 8 of 11 so far from the free throw line. Best free throw shooting performance we've seen out of them all year.
Yeah.
Once again, they've already made more than what the Lady Cavs attempted, just three.
Culver has two timeouts, Rochester has three. Keaton Stasiak has one more free one. The second one is good again. I believe she's 4-4 from the line.
5-6.
I believe she might be 5-6 from the line. Half court, full court press, Howard. left of the field on the baseline, wraps around pass, somehow gets to Hardy, top the key. Hardy stands and rotates on that right foot, and offside Montgomery. As that chases the basketball all around. Almost has her ball stolen. Picked up Montgomery, down to Stainer. 5:50 to play of the game. Culver by two. Stainer holds the top of the key, down to Schaefer. Schaefer against Stacey after the man-to-man defense. Schaefer holds at the volleyball line. Stands there and holds. Got a top Hardy. Hardy holds. One dribble, picks it up. They are in fast confusion right now, the Lady Cavs. Without their guard. Montgomery picks up a dribble. It's in the center circle out to Schaefer. A lot of time to play yet. 5:20 to play in the game. Culver by two and 34-32. Schaefer against Stasiak. Flips the defense at the free throw line. Dribbles out of trouble. Now back to the timeline. And she runs over Stasiak, and she's going to be called for a blocking foul.
Stasiak's going to pick up her fourth. I don't know if I agree with that.
Yeah, I would agree with Coach Stasiak there. She leaned right into it. And Team Stasiak picked up foul number four. Play in the ball game. Culver up 34-32. Kia Stasiak picks up foul number four. The inbound pass is stolen by Keaton. It'll stay with Rochester baseline left. I thought for sure they were going to whip around a travel.
I was afraid they were going to do that too. I thought she got pushed to the back earlier before she even got to the basket, but then they called a foul on the floor just before the quick shot up at Schaefer's third.
Now go in the corner, drives inside the lane, down low to Pollock, V against Hardy, jumper is going to foul! And Rochester once again is tied it, this time at 34, and the senior V Pollock will go to the line to shoot one,
and Hardy picks up her third.
5 minutes of play in the game. And I know we'd mentioned it as we're coming out of the halftime break. Let's go over the fouls again.
For the Lady Cavaliers, Llewellyn's on the bench with four, Hardy with three, and Schaefer with three. They're both on the floor still as Pollock lines up their first for the free throw.
No good, and we're tied at 34. Under 5 to play in the game. The Cavaliers have it. Llewellyn will go back into the game. I think that's a great move.
Yeah, Stasiak with four for the Lady Cavaliers. Malco with two.
Against the double team, Schaefer lowers her shoulder again, runs around the defense, and has the ball tipped out of bounds by Rochester. Will field Culver. Llewellyn comes back into the game, but Montgomery probably will sit, and that's exactly what will happen. Brad Thomas, I'm David Buncombe, at 4:45 to play in the game. We're tied at 34. It's been a dandy. Culver's biggest lead has been 8. Rochester has never led.
Both teams undefeated.
3 for Llewellyn. Good! Off the bench and drills a three. That's a big shot. Llewellyn up, and the Lady Cavs 23-30. Now Coach Earlmeyer chewing on the stacks a little bit. I don't know why anybody would want to be a referee, honestly. Look at my ex, good.
Lexa Holland with 10 points tonight.
Seriously, why would you want that meeting night in and night out? The verbal
assault.
Holland's second one, good again. Rochester was in one, 37-36. Full court press by the Lady Zebras. Llewellyn, over the top to Zahner, who gives out to Howard. Howard, ahead to Schaefer. Schaefer against Stasiak, drives to the baseline, wraps around past to Hardy. She pulls it out to Llewellyn. Llewellyn over the top of the defense to Howard. Howard to the free throw line, back to Llewellyn with 4:15 to play in the game. Culver by one at 37-36. Llewellyn around the defense, and the tape, floater on the way, it's good. Well, big shot by Llewellyn. She's got the last body from Culver, and they're back up by three. Back to the right wing, hesitates, picks up the dribble, bounce pass to Murphy. Murphy back to X.
Shoot that.
Ballin down to Malco. Pass down low to Murphy, or make that pass down low to B. Pollock. It's a tough one to handle. She stays from going out of bounds. And when she does get that, bang it off the leg of Llewellyn. It'll save us Rochester baseline right.
Llewellyn's given Lexa Holland a good foot and a half clearance on that defense. Holland just needs to pull the trigger.
4-3, right corner is X. The shot is good. And Coach Stasiak will use a 60-second timeout. We're tied at 39. You're listening. WROI.
Smith Farm Store has everything you need to get ready for fall. Cooler weather is on its way, and they have a great selection of United States stoves in stock, including pellet, multi-fuel, and furnaces. Get those outdoor projects finished with the help of steel during Fall Steel Days. Right now, buy an MS-271 chainsaw and get a free chain, or pick up a VG-56CE chainsaw and get a free safety combination pack. Smith Farm Store, your friendly local hardware store in Rochester and Plymouth.
And we're all about pets.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
3 minutes, 43 seconds to play in the game. We're tied at 39 here at Culver Community High School. Culver and Rochester both down to their final two timeouts. It'll be Culver Basketball after the three-point bomb, as well as go by Alexa Holliman.
Holliman with three threes tonight in this ball game, and she's tied this game up a couple of times here in the last quarter or so.
Inbound pass comes into Zahner. Zahner will just ring it up across the timeline. She looks at Coach Erlmeyer like, you want me to do what? I mean, that's what the reaction of her face looks
right.
Like.
Everybody else is covered up.
Holland, that makes it Howard. Zahner, high on the right side. Zahner drives around the defense, pull up 15-footer short. Rebound tipped around, Zahner comes out of there with it.
Rochester's got to have those boards.
Zahner back the way in, her shot no good. A foul coming on Murphy, that's going to send Donna Zahner to the line to shoot two. 3:18 to play in the game. We're tied at 39. And the junior Donna Zahner for Culver will go to the line to shoot two free throws for her Lady Cavs.
She got 10 points tonight in the game, but this is her first trip to the free throw line.
10 points and about 14 boards. First one for Zahner is no good. She'll have one more.
That's going to second free throw that Lady Cavs has missed tonight, but then they've only taken four.
Yeah.
So.
1-4 coming for Zahner, looking to push the Lady Cavs back in front by a point. Second for the junior. Good. 40-39. Culver back on top. That basically will be the end of the entire game. On
that's the Lady Cavs who shaped her down on the baseline, and that helped with the rebounding.
Ball tipped away, it's over to Falco. Falco will go into the left single land for the Schaefer. So good, but foul coming on Taylor Schaefer. That's going to send down to the line to shoot two.
Schaefer will pick up her four. Great steal defensively by Falco. She just jumped between the passing lane and was able to pick that ball up and down to herself.
Is left it here. Becky ready, fires the second one. Good this time, no rattle dead. And she's like, geez, finally.
Yeah.
40. Right up. 40. Schaefer has four fouls. Stasiak has four fouls.
Hardy has four fouls. Llewellyn has four fouls. Schaefer with four fouls for the Lady Cavs.
Llewellyn to Hardy in the corner, being trapped on this quadruple team. And we're going to have a timeout, Culver. 60. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1.
If you want to improve your farming efficiency and profits, rely on New Holland Precision Land Management Solutions from New Holland Rochester. They put the latest technology on your side to save you money for a faster return on your investment. PLM helps you achieve perfectly straight, repeatable passes, eliminating double application of seed and fertilizer, and allows you to analyze your field data. Discover what you can save with PLM Solutions from New Holland. They are experts in the field, so you can get more precision in yours. Stop by New Holland Rochester, Highway 25 South, today.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of North in Rochester.
Zebra basketball. WROI.
3:20 to play in the game. Culver down their final timeout. Rochester with two. It'll be Culver basketball right in front of their bench. 40-40. 2:20 to play in the game. Howard gets it in to Llewellyn. Llewellyn over the defense to Harney. In the lane, kicks it out to Schaefer. Schaefer, a couple of dribbles. Looking to dribble away from the traffic, gives the feeder to the timeline. Now to Harney in the center circle, left side to Llewellyn. Llewellyn around the defense. She over the head to Stater. Make that to Schaefer. Schaefer just loses the basketball. Now to Llewellyn. 2 minutes to play in the game. We're tied at 40. Llewellyn dribbles over the top of the defense to Stater. Not so sure Malcolm didn't get her fingers on that one. Stater to Harney in the lane. And then we're going to have a foul coming against Berserfi. And it'll be out of bounds to Culver. With a minute 51 to play in the game, we're tied at 40. Fast Solar's giving me a score. Triton Boys 35, Plymouth 23. Plymouth is the Rochester's next opponent. 20 points, 35-23. So 12 points. Long pass to Zaner at the free throw line. Donna drives, throws up a shot. It's good! Big shot by the junior. And Culver back up by two at 42-40. And finally does to Harney, a top over the defense to Zaner. Zaner holds above her head, left side now to Harney. A minute 20 to play in the game. Culver by two.
Oh,
and now the
puck
is hit by Collins. Comes out there with a mask.
Collins
too worried about getting bumped by Zaner. She forgot to make the layup. Schaefer picks away through traffic. No look past the Howler. First layup is good. Culver up by four. The minute to play in the game. Howard, her first 2 points. Across the timeline, we're going to have a foul quickly on it. Holland, and it'll be out of bounds to Culver right in front of the scorer's table. 48 seconds of play in the game. The Lady Cats lead 44-40. Again, Rochester's never left this game. They've tied it a couple of times. That's it. Howard wants to get it in. That's going to Zaner. He's going to back call on Culver. Rochester will get it back. 47 and a half to play in the game. And Rochester will take a 60-second timeout. You're listening to 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Dean Foods have been supplying dairy products to America's table since 1925. They're proud to bring you outstanding dairy products that promote a healthy living for you and your family. When shopping, load up on the perfect food. Dairy products from Dean Foods, Rochester. Dean Foods, created by nature, delivered by Dean.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
47 and a half seconds to play in the game. Culver leads 44-40. After the Culver turnover, Rochester will have the basketball.
Stasiak has four fouls. Pollock, Malco, and Murphy, all three with two, and Pollock doesn't have any.
Rochester's going to have to start fouling here soon. Holland gets a double team over the top to Murphy.
They need a quick bucket here.
To Holland, for three, left wing, good! 44-43, Culver on top with 33 seconds to play in the game. Full court press by Rochester.
There's Holland foul.
And Holland just fouled Taylor Schaefer, which
that made up six, so they still get it out of bounds. You'd like to see Murphy or Pollock or somebody.
Another one.
That puts them in the bonus. Okay.
Even if Schaefer makes both of these, Rochester still with a one-possession basketball game.
Schaefer's only 4 points tonight.
Taylor Schaefer has won the bonus for the Lady Cavs. First one away for the senior. Nope. Rebound to Sainer. Sainer goes up. Good.
That was a killer.
46-43, 25 seconds to play in the game. Back the long three to volleyball line. Good.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth. Enjoy your world. Wrestling your back. And college and pro football continue. There's plenty to do. So whether it's heading for the gym, holiday open houses, and getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
19 seconds to play in the game. Alexa Holland just bombed one to the volleyball line and win, and we're tied at 46.
She hit her fifth three-pointer, her third one in this quarter. And again, Alexa Holland ties the score. That's like the third time she tied this score on a three-point shot tonight.
Rochester is out of timeout. Culver has won. It'll be out of bounds to Culver. They'll need to go the length of the floor. Holland has three. Malco has two. Stasiak with four. Murphy with two. Pollock with none.
The only one that can't foul at that point is King.
Stasiak, yep.
Telephone is your lifeline. Lifeline is a federal benefit that makes monthly telephone service more affordable for eligible low-income households. A subscriber that meets criteria as established by the Indiana Utility Regulatory Commission and lives within the Rochester Telephone Company service area must be a participant in one of the following programs to qualify for the Lifeline benefit: Medicaid, food stamps, supplementary security income, federal public housing assistance, low-income home energy program, temporary assistance to needy families, national school lunch free program, and income-based federal eligibility. Only one Lifeline benefit per household is allowed. For more information or to see if you qualify for Lifeline assistance, please call Rochester Telephone Company at 223-2191.
Basketball, WROI.
Time here period we go with the Lady Cavaliers and the Rochester Lady Zebras, 9-46. Rochester has never led in this contest. And the X factor in this game, in my opinion, is Angela Llewellyn.
Yeah, you're right. She's got four fouls for the Lady Cavaliers. She's a point guard. She had 5 points off the bench in the fourth quarter to propel the Lady Cavaliers and keep them alive here in this game.
It'll be a jump ball again. Pollock and Schaefer will jump. Ball is up and a tip controlled by Culver. Hardy down low. Sainer. And Llewellyn now, and she'll come the other way.
Yeah, Lady Cavaliers, when she was out on the bench with her foul trouble, they had trouble getting the ball off the floor.
Hardy shot, good to foul. He just picked up another. And that's going to send Michaela Hardy to the line that you wanted.
She's got 17 tonight for the Lady Cavaliers. And her three fouls.
Hardy at the line to shoot one, looking to push his lead to three. Again, 4 minutes in the overtime period. We've just used 14 seconds of it.
Lexa Hall had 11 points in that fourth quarter.
Hardy's free throw, no good. And good block out by Pollock. Give to Holland. Rochester down by two.
724-223-2166 or stop by their downtown location at 124 East 8th Street, Rochester, or visit their website at www.smithsawyerins.com. Smith Sawyer Smith Insurance, protecting individuals and families since 1932.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Time to play in overtime. Time to 50. Culver uses the timeout. They're down to one. Rochester also has one. It'll be out of bounds to the Cavaliers right in front of the score table.
So we lost Llewell at the fouls for the Lady Cavaliers.
That's a big deal.
It is. Hardy has four, as does Schaefer for the Lady Cavaliers. For the Lady Zebras, Stasiak still playing with four. Murphy with three. Holland with three.
Well, it's not... So it'll be out of bounds to Culver. 2:29 to play in overtime. We're tied at 50. Tanner gets the basketball inbound from Howard. She works against Murphy, the man-to-man defense. Tanner picks the basketball left out, pass to Howard. Howard, down to Hardy.
Oh, looking back to the
wide open Tanner.
This wide open. She's still open down low.
Hardy's going to get rid of it. She's got a dribble, and she just does a 4.5 seconds. Howard now has him. 2:05 to play in the game in overtime.
And you're right, Llewellyn's already desperately needed on the floor for the Lady Cavs.
50-50, 2 minutes to play in overtime. Tanner holds against Murphy. Rides left, goes to the basket, and before the shot, Murphy's going to pick up foul number four. And Tanner is holding her left knee.
That's not good.
Maynard still on the floor.
Lady Cavaliers already with enough knee trouble for most folks for a season.
Still on the floor. Now the trainer comes out and will take a look at Zahner so
they can help afford to lose another one.
No, that's right. So we're going to take, nope, she's going to be helped up. Not really putting a whole lot of weight on that knee. In fact, she will be assisted to the sideline. She can't put any
no
weight on that knee.
No. They may take her straight to the locker room.
Well, so, Zahner will come out of the game.
15 points tonight. She probably had near 15 rebounds to go along with.
At least.
Yeah, that's a huge blow for the Lady Cavaliers.
So, Courtney Zellier, a 5'5 freshman, will come in and shoot free throws for her Lady Cavs. We're tied at 50 with a minute 54 to play.
Wow.
In overtime.
Talk about a big big chore to ask of a freshman to come in off the bench at a tie basketball game in overtime and shoot free throws.
Now you're at the free throw line. Shoot, no good. Rebound to Stasiak. 50-50. Stasiak gallops down the sideline like a little horse.
Holler to Holland. He wants her to have the basketball.
A minute 40 to play this in overtime. 50-50. Much of the basketball to Murphy. Looks at a three fast step. Top to Malco. Becky holds. 2-3 zone by Lady Cavs. Murphy holds above her head. One dribble down X off the game. A minute 25.
Desperately trying to work that ball down low to Pollock. She's working against Hardy. Hardy with four fouls.
Murphy drives the baseline. Stop. Out to Montgomery with 58. She travels. Rochester will get it back. Up by two with 54.5 seconds to play in the game.
Watch the Lady Zebras pull this out to the four corners.
Culver will use their last timeout. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball. 93.1 WRY.
Your Fulton County RDMC is proud to offer the new faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
54 4 and a half seconds to play in overtime. Rochester has their first lead of the game. It comes right, well, it came at the 58-second mark, and it's right now at 52-50.
Yeah, and they have the basketball. They've got to go the full length of the floor. And Sean Zahner, the Lady Cavaliers, has come out of the locker room and checked back into the basketball game. She is limping. She's not going to be 100%, and she is crying because she knows she's in some pain.
Yeah.
But she's going to cut it out for her team and her teammates here in the last 54 seconds.
Rochester has one timeout. Culver out of timeout. Now the Lady Cavs in a full-court press. Have not seen that yet tonight. Malco with 54 seconds, and she has the ball tipped out of bounds by Schaefer with 51.8 playing overtime. Rochester runs 52-50. Now Malco will trigger it in against the
full court pressure.
Full court press. Gets it in to Murphy. Murphy holds with 50. To Malco with 48. Ahead to X with 46. X around the defense with 43. X dribbles around with 40.
Coach Stasiak was hollering, magic. I'm guessing that means dribble until somebody fouls him.
Stasiak to Malco with 30. Coach Perlmeyer's asking for it. A foul, and that's pretty impressive. Schaefer kicks that up into the upper deck with 30 seconds to play. In overtime, Rochester up 52-50.
That'll win into next week.
It did. 30 seconds to play in overtime. Rochester up 52-50. Murphy will trigger it in right in front of the scorer's table. Murphy, steady, gets it to X. X then gets to Schaefer. Schaefer just fouled out. That's what it did. That's going to send Holland to the line to shoot two.
Holland, 2, 4, 6, 7 of 8 from the free throw line tonight. She's got 22 points. And was almost single-handedly brought the Lady Beavers back into this basketball game.
Jayla Schaefer is done. She is fouled out. At the line is Alexa Holland with 2 free throws, looking to push this lead to 4. Rochester up 52-50. They have left for the middle. 30 seconds of this game.
Schaefer fouled out with 4 points.
Holland has pushed it to a two-possession game. 53-50 Rochester, the biggest lead of the game. 29 seconds of play overtime. One more coming for the Bulls. Abbott Monster.
He's got 14 points in the fourth quarter and the overtime combined.
Holland's second one. Good again. 53-50. Now Rochester with 1. Across the timeline. Gives to the freshman. Salyer. Out of Montgomery to Zahner. 17 seconds. Ball's knocked out of bounds. It'll see with Culver baseline right. 54-50 Rochester in OT. Culver basketball out of bounds with 17 seconds to play in overtime. Howard looks to get it in. Lobs it into Zahner. Out of Montgomery. Down to Howard. First three with 14 seconds. Gets to Holland with 8. Dyer then calls foul. Holland with 6.5 to play in overtime. Rochester up 54-50. What a fantastic basketball game.
It was. Like you said, Rochester trailed the entire basketball game. They were able to tie it up by a 3-pointer from Alexa Holland in the final seconds of regulation. And then get the lead with about 50 seconds left in overtime.
Meyer will bring Donna Zahner and put her on the bench. Hardy across the timeline with 3. Good move in the hands of Murphy with 1. With 0. That'll do it. Rochester fight the entire game to get a lead. They finally get it with a minute to play in overtime and win it 55-50. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.